if you give me this one, right? So here's a possible block, right? Or a possible hit here. Notice that my motion is vertical, yeah? Okay. What I've changed is my angle. Because if I change my angle, see? Right? If she comes in with a backhand, okay? So here. As I change my angle, right? Will determine a lot of times, right? Does that make sense?
So we're blocking.
Well, you can block or hit. It's the same motion, right? So, this block going vertical here, right? So there's a block. A lot of people call this when we do this, right? So here, okay. But instead of addressing the weapon, if I change my reach just a little bit, I'm okay here, right? So I can start hitting a mainly target, right? If I change my stay on it just a little bit, I'm okay here. So it's the same move each time, yeah?
No matter where I move.
Okay. And again, it's a vertical motion.
As I lead.
That's just using the hitting edge, like I said earlier, remember? But we've got more than just that hitting edge. Okay. So if I come here, here this way. Hitting with a punya. Okay. I'm using, remember check hand?
Okay, so
remember check hand from last weekend, right?
Remember
this, right? From that three. So I'm going to use that. I'm going to follow the shoulder. Excuse me. Remember, follow the shoulder, right? Come here, everyone. Okay, follow the shoulder here. Boom. Okay. Then it would be more, go lefty when you swing against them. Just for now, since it's brand new. But even that, okay? Even that, you're right. Here. Can still do it.
Get shoulder down.
Come over here.
This was count.
Okay. Now, the check hand is really going to work best when, here. Before their power gets in, right? So, for her to swing with power, the shoulder and the hip have to engage. Okay, once that, okay, watch. With this, there's nothing there, right? It's just the arm.
My hip, shoulder engage right away.
See the difference in the right? So for the check hand to work, because you catch him here.
It's going to be more like a swing.
Before all this engages and the movement starts, right? So she comes in here. This is where you need to be. We can't always be here, though. This is optimal.
Hopefully with that, they're like, oh.
So the other option is don't be there,
and then she'll light away.
Boom.
Those are something best
places to be when they strike. Before it happens, or after it's done. So we gotta practice something, right? We gotta practice something. So we find a happy middle, here. Okay. Or? So remember going up too, right? So it's not just down, it's also up. In this particular case, I use the tip. Okay?
So the idea was to...
So she comes in this way, right? So here. Crack. There's your vertical. If you need to get a block, say you're a little bit late and you had a block, so there's your block. If you go here. See? So I just, yeah. So again, so it's a combination of your range. Range is dictated by your footwork. So if I step closer, I've got close range. If I step further, I've got long range. And everything in between, right? Your reach, which is dictated by your arms and also your weapon, right? So reach is going to be different. Right? So your range and reach are kind of related. I can't be here and use this weapon. Right? I've got to adjust my range for my reach. Yeah? And then timing. Timing is when not only is your timing, but theirs. So it's not just timing is when you move, right? But it's also when they move. So you have to, unfortunately, you have to be aware of when they move and what they do, and their range and their reach as well as your own.